Hey everybody, Texas Stroke here at Lancaster Performance Chapel on StyroMobiles.com. It is decent time, 8:20. I'm getting out here again, trying to make some progress, get the shop cleaned up a little bit, so once my hand is healed up, I can get right into working and have less stuff to trip over. So, basically, once again, my apologies in advance if I sound terrible. It's something I've been trying to get over, can't seem to shake it. We'll see how that pans out, but as long as we don't lose our voice, we will have timestamps down below. If you want to kind of spoil the video, you know, pass with the thumbnail reveals, you can do that. Skip ahead to the items of interest, whatever floats your boat. But this is, in fact, a special video. Why is it special, you ask? Well, it's not stuff I picked up locally. It's not stuff from a big box store or some random retailer online. It's not German tools, not Japanese tools. It's not some Mopar part or crazy stuff we're doing to a vehicle. This is a celebratory video for the channel hitting 5,000 subscribers, and what I had said long ago was, you know, we're gonna kind of have like targets and, you know, goals, things we would achieve together. So 5,000 subscribers, the plan was to do a Matco tool haul. Spoiler alert, 10,000, I said that's when we would finally buy something from Snap-on, and we'll probably put Mac in there at like 7,500. What's beyond that, I don't know. We're not really to the point of me even needing to worry about that. If you want to find out and make me worry about that, feel free to spread the good word on the channel. Now, that said, it's not just, you know, 5,000 subscriber Matco tool haul. This was me seeking your input on items to procure. And didn't get a ton of feedback, and the feedback that I got was pretty much all the same thing. And it kind of revolved around the item that I was really wanting to try from them. And then some of you, veteran viewers of the channel, probably have a pretty good idea of some of the other things I bought. So, first thing first, buying from Matco online is expensive. There's a dealer I see his truck in the area all the time. He has never, for whatever reason, stopped by work, so that's kind of strange, but in all honesty, that's sort of something I see with salesmen across the board. You know, when I was in college, I couldn't get away from salespeople. They were there all the time. They would come by weekly or bi-weekly. Some companies even had two. You know, if like the middle-aged dude didn't appeal to you and sell some stuff, they'd send out, you know, like the younger, you know, more attractive chick to try and make the sale. And those days are gone, and it's not just, you know, from like the last 2 years. It's sort of a trend. You know, I mean, like the last 5 to 8 years just sort of disappeared. You had like that older generation kind of retire, get out of the game, and it's sort of a deal. If you want to buy something, you'll probably just call us. Nobody's really pursuing sales, you know, or like introducing themselves, stopping by, seeing if there's anything they can do for you. I can't think of the last time that's happened, aside from people being lost and needing directions. So with that said, buying it from Matco, in my opinion, online, fairly smooth process. Their website could really use some help. Again, this is all subjective. This is all straight up honest opinions. If I was able to buy direct from Knipex and they had the same setup, I would give the same criticism. When you try to search their website by, let's just say, a specific screwdriver size, you know, I hope you have time to fan through, you know, like anywhere from 5 to 17 pages, because that's what you're going to need to do to find the item that you want. It's kind of bizarre that a company that big, you know, with that much manpower, wouldn't have a better website. I'm sure their end goal, of course, is, you know, to sell through distributors and on the trucks, but there's a lot of people that don't have a dealer in their area. There's a lot of people, for whatever reason, would have to order online. And I feel like they're kind of dropping the ball there. The packing list could also use some serious help. I'm not going to lie. It would be nice if you had the part number, a description, and perhaps a price. Just going to throw that out there. Again, it's none of it's the end of the world, but it's not going to be a seamless experience for you. There's going to be some struggle to find what you want. In fact, there might be something that you would like better, but you won't be able to find it, and you'll just get exhausted, and you'll settle for something else. So if you want to order online, set aside some time. But aside from that, everything showed up. It was what I ordered. It arrived, and we're going to get into it. So, like I said, the consensus from the majority of you, I offered for you to suggest great items, items that you personally use, you know, and love and think I would love, items that you just, maybe you don't use them yourself, but you're like, man, you know, that guy, he's going to love this thing. I offered for you to suggest comically bad things with the caveat that you tell me, hey, you know, you gotta get this, but it's a piece of junk. I want to see your reaction to it. And for the most part, it was just a ton of overlap. And that's kind of what I ran with. Again, the end goal wasn't to spend a ton of money. It was just to kind of whet our appetite, see what we think of some of the tools. And we're going to get right off on probably the worst thing, worse, in my opinion, than the less than ideal website. And we're just going to throw it down. This is their part number, SO. That's O as in octopus, not zero as in your bank account. SO81P2C. This is going to set you back $17.10. It's got a quarter inch something with it, might be a shaft, and it's going to be an inch and a half long. And if you're thinking, well, is this an extension or a screwdriver? Probably a screwdriver knowing this guy. Well, you'd be correct. That's exactly what it is. So, this is where I kind of get a little salty. You sit there and you think, oh, what's the problem? You know, you got orange and black, it's a cool looking driver, it's nice, you'll be able to compare a stubby, you know, what's the problem? This is what you do on this channel, you know? Well, here's the deal, you know, even with, you know, smaller companies, let's say Tecton, for example, if you went there to this website and Tecton had this same driver with their logo on it, it would give you the country of origin. Now, buying from Matco, I sort of knew some things and I assumed the rest, and this was incorrect on my part of the assumption, would have been sourced from America, most likely. If we flip this thing over, this, I don't know that you can see it too well down there, but there's the part number. That's, what does that say? Made for, it's included. Specifications in Taiwan. Okay, that's right, this is from Taiwan. Is that a problem? Yes and no. No, it's not a problem because I'm sure they make a decent screwdriver, but yes, it is a problem because $17.10 is way more money than anyone needs to be spending for a screwdriver from Taiwan. That's why so many things are made overseas. It's because the price is low. People can sell them at a lower price point. They can make more money. It's not what I was expecting. That really sucks. Transparency would be very, very much appreciated. So, with that aside, man, that's buttery smooth. That's not made in Taiwan, Matco. Don't buy that. If they ever get cuttix, don't buy it from your Matco guy. You're going to spend too much money. Now, also on that note, let's be totally transparent. If you've got a great dealer, they'll cut you deals. They'll throw in freebies. If you buy X items or a set or something they're trying to push, you don't have that online. You just get like that raw, you know, website experience. So, right here, this is not a bad shape, actually, now that it's in hand. It's got the tri-lobe here for anti-roll, which was not very effective, but somewhat effective. It's a good color scheme. The orange is a little brighter than I'd want it to be. This isn't like a hemi orange. It's more of like a tangerine or something. There's really not a grip surface here. It's just sort of rubberized, and my thumb, even in a glove, is sort of sliding off. Gloves by Alpha, link down below, save 20%. I make nothing off that. Just trying to save you money, unlike the Matco website. So, right there, that's kind of it. This will be used, as you guessed it, later on for testing and comparison. We've accrued a pretty decent set of stubby drivers at this point in time. So, obviously, one of the end goals would be to be stubby, and you also need it to be comfortable and able to turn. So you'd be amazed how many stubby drivers miss one or multiple of those points. But this one, at least, as odd as it may seem, picture yourself in tight quarters. This would actually be a functional driver. We've got Matco 1, Matco. So we got three places with Matco. So pretty much anywhere that it rolls, you're going to have that. The camera is sort of washing the orange out a little bit more. If we come back over here to the Picard, man, that's got to get used to buying that. It's doing the same thing to it, but they're both, especially the driver, slightly darker than they appear, at least here in the camera. I don't know what it'll look like when I edit it. But if the color is important to you, which I assume it would be, that's something to keep in mind. So again, the problem I have primarily with this item, number one, they were not at all transparent. That was going to be made in Taiwan. That very well may have led me to purchase something electrical and probably spend around the same amount of money. And if they were transparent about it, you know, I just would have been like, yeah, that's a little much for that. And I probably would have passed, but not having the information, That does not set well with me, sort of seems a bit shady. Where I learned of this being made in Taiwan is from our next item, which is going to be part number SO. Again, another thing, if you ever are in a position in your life, whether you have your own business or you're helping someone set something up, O and zero, not necessarily the best ideas for part numbers. If you're going to use one of them, try to just use one of them, zero, okay? Don't put them together. If you had them back to back, you could easily distinguish between them. But if there's not that slash in the middle, not everyone understands, you know, like the zero is kind of taller and the O is fatter, you know, especially when you use all caps or a mix of letters. Just, if at all possible, avoid them. You know, that's I and L type of a thing, you know. Just be smart and your customers will thank you at some point in time. Where this one really kind of irked me is I could see this arrived in a bag. These drivers were in basically a Ziploc bag, if you will. And glaring at me when I first got it was made in Taiwan, to Matco specifications. Again, not a huge deal, but at the price point, this one's $22.45, we're basically like in Nipros territory, okay? Nipros is very, very fancy. It's like jewelry. It's made in Japan. It's actually made in Japan. And it's at around that same price point. So that's sort of my beef here, is simply these things are a bit overpriced. I'm just going to come out and not cut the corners. I'm just going to tell you what I really think. They're overpriced. So this one, again, not a terrible shape. This one feels decent in hand. I specifically went with the black glove so we wouldn't have like crazy contrasting colors or anything. But the thing here, no striking cap, but we do have a hex bolster. This is our standard test screwdriver, 4-inch shaft, number 2 Phillips. Let's go ahead. These will, if you didn't know, be pretty much identical. So looks to be, like I said, decent quality. I'm not going to say it's a piece of trash until we use it, but I'm going to say this is overpriced considerably. Tri-lobe design. Now, I'm not going to lie. This is where I went wrong, all right? When I saw these on their site as I browsed about, my thoughts were, hey, you know, that's a tri-lobe. I kind of think that might be like a different handle style from Witte. And clearly, when we got these in and I saw Taiwan, I learned that that was not the case, but the 17 and the 22, that was sort of my justification. I assumed this was a handle I'd never experienced from Witte that they must do specifically for Matco. And again, not the case. The closest I could think that's similar to that, I kind of think some of the Carlisle drivers might be. I don't have any. But the Teng Tools is a similar shape. It's obviously not got the tri-lobe feature, you know, on the back of the side, but in terms of shape, it does share some similarities. So if you recall back to when we brought those in. But that is our orange Matco set right there. Again, we'll use those later on. We'll get to test them. Who knows? It could turn out to be the best screwdriver in the world. And at that point in time, we say, hey, it's totally worth the $22.45. As of right now, if I could have gotten that pair for like $9.99, I'd think that would be fair. As is, we're all in pretty much at $40. So, not too happy there, but hey, it is what it is. So, moving on, it's going to get better. That's the good news, is if you think, man, this is sad, you're just sitting here complaining, you're trashing them, you know, you're doing this intentionally. Totally not the case, and it's going to start getting better right now. So, the thing is, when we come in, we're now up to $26.35 on this item. This item's part number, SPG84P2CA. This should look familiar to you, and we'll see if you can recognize it, okay? We'll drop it down like this. You should already know. If you've been a veteran viewer of this channel and you don't know, you need to go back and do your homework, okay? Spin this sucker down, and yeah, you guessed it. This is a Matco green screwdriver. Totally different than that. This is a tri-lobe, you betcha. But this one is made in Germany. That's right, this is made by Witte. So, this, if you didn't know, we can come in and let's actually try to cut this off because I feel like the plastic is occluding some of that. I don't know if you were to buy a set, if it would be wrapped. Oh man, just got the bad part of my head there. Not with a knife, not with a knife, with the screwdriver handle. It's just a little too much pressure. But I don't know if they would have this protective cellophane stuff on them if you were to order a set. I don't know if it would come in a box or what exactly. Yeah, get that out of here. I will tell you, this is dirty, and it's not for me because these were brand new gloves. I don't know that the camera's going to show it, and it's a very minor thing, but we have to mention it because in a tool haul, I make sure everything is new. If this looks vibrant and that looks like there's a dark spot, there absolutely is. Now, what's interesting, they did a great job here, Witte and Matco, for specking this out, because if you can't tell, in addition to the name, they've actually got the logo there, so that's a very cool touch. I was completely unaware of that until we got this out of the packaging. Flip it over. You knew they were going to get it in there somewhere, and where Witte did is right here, made in Germany. If you're a stickler for country of origin and you're picking yourself up some Matco screwdrivers, this is what you're going to want to do. Again, the ones back there from Taiwan could be fantastic. They could be superb. They could be the greatest ones that we own. As of right now, I wouldn't expect that, especially at the price points. And I would advise you to go this route. You can kind of tell an immediate difference in the shafts right there, the tips in particular. But here, this is another cool thing they did working with Witte. I mean, it's nothing crazy, nothing groundbreaking, because Witte prints right there as well. But if we could get the glare to go away. Matco. You can sort of see it. We've got the Matco, the logo, part number, Phillips designation on the shaft. What this is going to translate to for you, okay? Witte, they're still doing the Tri-Lobes. I personally love them. They've got the Max, the MaxxPro, and the MaxxPro Plus, right? So, if I come in here, I'm gonna grab this one, okay? This is basically an equivalent, but it's got the hex bolster. Same, I mean, you know, you get the feel for it, right? So, very, very obvious, you know, who's behind these, made in Germany. We'll come in right here. This is one of my favorite sets. These are still not available in just a number two Phillips. They've, I guess, got so much back stock. But this is Witte's new color scheme. It used to be this, and while it looks really cool and is unique, they would come in filthy. Like, there's stains all over this handle from Matco, even though it was wrapped. I don't know if it's something Matco did when they wrapped it. I don't know if Witte did it. I don't know if this is just something you expect from their drivers. They're going to come in with, like, greasy fingerprint type of things. They looked really bad on these. Going black and blue not only looks good, but it also conceals that. You know, if that's a regular occurrence, if it's something that smears off on the machine as it goes through a roller, who knows how it occurs. It can honestly be somebody like sits there and eats candy, you know, as they pack these off the line. I don't know. But I personally absolutely love this handle. They've performed well for me all the times I've used them. And if you're wondering, like, hey, you haven't used that, it's number two Phillips. Nope, this is my torque set, so I get used quite a bit. And right here, though, they kind of do that trademark thing where there's just that sort of friction material, right? It's designed, you know, A, to provide you better grip, but B, if your hands have something on them, antifreeze, oil, transmit, whatever, it's going to be less likely to slip. So it's an upgrade, if you will. So sort of the cream of the crop from Witte in Matco fashions and Matco specs right there. If you're curious, again, the price on that sucker, $26.35. Do I think that's a fair price? No. I think that's a bit high, I'm not going to lie. Case in point, the standard equivalent from Witte, exact same driver, you know, number two Phillips, 4-inch shaft, you're going to be looking at around $11, standard pricing at KC Tool. So you could basically buy almost three of them, two, and have some money left over. The thing I will say, if you're particular about colors, that's where this would come in. If you love the Witte drivers, but you're like, man, that gray, he's right, I have those, it gets so filthy, I can't stand it. You know, you might not be a total slob, you might not have to have your tools look perfect, but it's just a deal where it bothers you. You know, you clean things up after jobs, you put it back in. If it wears, it wears, but those just wear prematurely, they stain, there's nothing you can do, and it bothers you, just ticks away at you when you're, you know, subtly trying to sleep at night type of a deal. The colors have that advantage. Also, anyone trying to color code things, if green's your favorite color, orange is your favorite color, they've got red, they've got high-vis, they do some pretty cool colors. Sadly, no blue. That might be a segue for later. It's just one of those things. $15 more for the color? I don't really think so. But if there's a sale or a promotion, you know, or if your driver's like, you know, hey, if you buy this and blank item, you know, I'll cut you a deal. That's when you really start to be able to justify slightly more to get the colors you want. But again, if this is what you're after, my advice, go to KC Tool. You don't have to go to KC Tool. You can go anywhere, but you're going to pay considerably less than we just did for this guy. Now, perhaps the most exciting item that we're going to have showcased so far is coming up. And some of you might have an idea of what it might be, but it's probably not what you're thinking it is. I'll just say that right now. So this is going to be part number SG81P2. Does that give it away? The P2 part? BA. What does BA stand for? I've got my theories. But this is going to be a little stubby action for us from the Vitline. Why this is important, I don't believe even in sets that I've purchased, I don't think I've got a Witte stubby, and this is now a stubby, and it's in green. It's got the felt pads here, you know, shouldn't say felt, whatever that material is. But right there, you can kind of see the part number, the size. It's a bit stubbier than our Taiwanese one. It's also a bit more compact. It also maintains a better tri-lobe profile. And like I said, this is big, not just because of the Matco and the color scheme. I didn't have this. This is something like you go in and you're like, oh, hey, you know, I want to test out stubbies too, and I definitely need to get that. What's it cost at KC Tool? $5? I'm going to go grab it. They don't have them. They do not have a standalone stubby. So this was a very cool acquisition. Now, price point, sadly, $17.95. That's, again, a bit much. You've got to realize, like, what we're paying here for, that's like an MSRP thing. Think of it like a car dealer, your tool truck. So where you go to KC Tool or, you know, buy direct from someone, like, you've got their profit margin marked in. When you do this, you've got the profit margin marked in for Matco, and then you've got the profit margin specced out, you know, the range for the dealer. And that basically means you pay a lot more money. That's what sucks about that. But like I said, this was the 5K deal, so we wanted to go ahead and pull the trigger there. So we did. What we're going to do now is go to the next item. It's our slightly bigger item. I have not opened it. I guess I'll have to prove that to you so you know I'm not lying. And I'm very, very excited about this one. This is part number BFR128BLFB. It's going to be from their 88 line. They're going to obviously have 88 tooth. That probably tells you what it is. It's 12 was in the part number. It's 12 inches. And it's got what they call their ergo handle. So keep that in mind. And then it is a locking flex head. And just throwing it down right here. Boom, look at that glorious sight. Don't you love it? Oh, sorry, you're looking in a bag, aren't you? So this again, not open. I have not used this thing. I have wanted to. That's honestly why I'm recording this now. This is not a pressing video. I have other videos of higher priority. I'm filming this now because I want this open and I want to start using it. Now there's also one more item that we're going to showcase next that I also want to use. Flipping this thing over, there she is. You guessed it. This is kind of the image that I picked when I was kind of pushing the 5K tool haul. And the consensus from you, at least the ones of you that chime in on YouTube with comments, was definitely get that. Yeah, you didn't really care if I got anything else, but it was definitely get this. Some of you did suggest like a really, really long quarter inch flex. I nearly did it. But this is, to me, I know for some of you, you know, you like buy off the trucks all the time and, you know, you just throw the money around. I'm still, like, we brought in a lot of stuff, but I'm still doing that thrifty. Like, it may not seem like it, but, like, I wait for sales. I go on tool of the day. You got to think, like, this is kind of like a year-round deal for me. So it's not just, oh, hey, got to crank a video out. Like, some of this stuff I've had sitting around for, you know, months. So that's where I stand here. So price point on this guy, $189.95. I don't think that's really terrible. Where like the Taiwanese screwdriver, I'm going to just flat out call it out. This I have a little variance in, and it's not because I love the color scheme, it's not because it's blue, it's not because it's black chrome. Those are all great. This is made in America. I'm willing to pay more for that. It should be, you know, you either, from the feedback I get from people I know, it mirrors pretty much exactly what you see on YouTube and on forums or wherever you are about tools. People either love these ratchets or they have nothing but trouble with them and hate them. I personally, straight up honest, have zero experience with Matco ratchets, so I couldn't tell you. I'm going to find out. And yes, even though this will look cool, I'm going to use it. I have one other flex head. I bought it for myself for a birthday present, and it's my only flex head. So this will kind of, you know, be nice to have as well. The black chrome, big deal for me. The blue handle, really big deal for me. Why we can't get, you know, like hand tools, and I don't know, it makes no sense to me. It makes absolutely no sense to me. You go to Harbor Freight and you look at like their new service carts, right? And you look at the reviews, and you're not necessarily concerned with like 3 stars, 5 stars, 1 star, whatever. If you just look at like the volume of reviews and you look at the carts, and you've got black and you've got red, your classic like Craftsman colors, right? And then you go and you look at yellow, it's kind of like, oh, that's what you'd expect. There's more people buying black and red. Then you go and you look at, like, the specialty colors, blue, orange, green. And guess what? They significantly outsell the others, at least in terms of reviews, right? Which you would think would mirror the actual sales. It's kind of like people watching a YouTube video. You know, 5,000 people may watch it. A tenth of those people might actually, you know, like or dislike the video, and then, like, a quarter of those people might actually leave a comment. It's just progressively, you know, scales down from the top. That's the same with everything in life, really. And the case in point right here, $189.95, that is a hard pill to swallow. I don't think any of the German ratchets we brought in, the Nipros, we're typically around half that price. You know, maybe like 120-ish might have been the highest we went, and that's for like super beefy extendable half inch drive, like cream of the crop stuff. You know, 189, again, a very high, but the aesthetics are pretty much spot on for me. But aside from that, made in America, and then I'm going out, it's like 50-50 to me. I feel like if I had everyone line up, half of you would say this is a great ratchet, you're gonna love it. Mine's awesome. I've had it for X years. It's my favorite. I like it better than brand X, Y, and Z. And the other half of you are going to say, oh, don't even spend your money on that. So in situations like that, I think it kind of ultimately comes down to you. You have to try it yourself. You either have to side with the negative people that say, you know, it's terrible. Just don't buy it. I'm going to be your best friend by telling you this and saving you your hard-earned money. Or you go with the positive side and you're like, well, you know, everyone over here says it's great. When it's split that evenly, you really kind of have to say, like, okay, do I like this, and do I have the curiosity level enough to try it? And in my case, again, being only my second flex head, it's like, well, you know, it's sort of justifiable. So here we are. Plus, it was the most requested item from you. And back to the point I was making at the time, the long quarter inch, you know, really, really oversized, over-length quarter inch one, that, ooh, yeah. It looks nice out of the bag, man. That bag was doing you no justice at all, my friend. It's a bad look, you know, through that cloud of plastic. But going back to the long quarter inch deal, I opted to wait. I could see the advantages of having that, kind of like several of you suggested. The thing is, if I wind up hating this, I don't want to have sunk $400 into the line. I'd rather, you know, get this one, say, man, that looks really good, but it sucked, and not have another $200 sunk in. So this is sort of the guinea pig. We're going to see what we think of it. And on that note, I'm going to pause real quick because we're about to time out. And just like that, we are back. So as I said, this thing looks killer out of the packaging. If you didn't know, after all this time, if you had no inclination, I like black and blue. I like orange and black, you know. These are my standard color schemes. Again, why people don't take advantage of this. This is why I just last night, you know, filmed that Ernst video, and I'm emailing them, and I'm like, hey, you know, have you guys ever considered expanding that? This is kind of proof in the pudding. You know, like, I don't know if I would have had, you know, the Matco deal you know, go this way if this was not available. So it kind of gets me in. It could be like a gateway drug for people. The Hazette 916 HP. Pick that thing up when it's on sale. It could easily become one of your favorite ratchets. And next thing you know, you have the full set, or you're trying out their screwdrivers or wrenches. You know, who knows? There's that one item. And when it performs favorably for people, they're like, well, you know, I kind of like that Matco, you know. And so next time, you know, if you're sitting there and you like a specialty tool or even something basic and common, you're like, yeah, I'm going to go get that from Matco. You know, it's kind of Harbor Freight's the same way. You go in there and have a bad experience, you'll hate the place. If you get something and you're like, man, that thing actually turned out to be good. I saved so much money. It's still working well. I don't know what people are talking about. That place is great. That's sort of where you stand. And for me, again, having zero experience with Matco, this is where we stand. So this one, again, I don't think, and I'm no expert in any of this stuff, but I don't believe Matco actually manufactures anything, which is kind of weird. I'm not going to lie. That sort of ties in with more of like a middleman, you know, price gouge type of a deal. But I guess, you know, they probably spec things out at least. I mean, there's one thing, right? But the bottom line, I don't know who makes this, but it is Matco branded. They've got the part number there. The Ergo Grip looks good. I'm not gonna lie, online that looked like a very fat grip. This is a pretty thin grip. It's not microscopic, but I think it'll work. But I can already tell you I would have liked a little bit more material there. It's just one of those things, like my hand is here and it's ready to go, but I'm gonna have to do this now. I have to physically squeeze and close my hand more. It's just a bit undersized. It's not terribly undersized, but it is a bit undersized in my opinion. If you got big mitts, you got long fingers, you got long hands, fat fingers, fat, whatever it might be, you might have the same complaint. If you have smaller hands, this would be, and you know, that might be their deal. They think, well, we'd rather have it small than big, because if this is huge, you know, at some point even I am going to complain, like, hey, I can't get my hand around the back side of the ratchet handle. We're probably going to not be able to control it very well. So I can see the logic either way, but in my opinion, this is a little shy of the sweet spot. And again, I'm sure some of you that have this will be able to chime in. Flipping it around, I just did. It looks like we're going to be sealed with a circlip there. We've got the selector. Whoa. Okay. I thought I just articulated that, and I was like, this is worse than the VHA. It's like, if I touch it harder, it's going to fly off over to the edge of the workbench. But yeah, that's actually pretty positive retention there. The black chrome appears to get a little matte up here, like the handle's got a decent sheen to it, and then as you get to the head, it's almost like it doesn't have the same luster. I don't know if you can tell what I'm talking about. Like, this is like deep gloss black, and then this is like a semi-gloss. You know, we're talking chrome, yes, but you know, think about it. You start with the Krylon can here, and you're sitting there like, yeah, this gloss is cool, and then you run out, you know, and it's like Sunday, and you need to get this painted before Monday rolls around, and all you had on the shelf was semi-gloss, and that's kind of the vibe I'm getting there. Again, that is the business end. It'll be what takes the brunt of hits and everything anyway, so it would probably get scuffed justifiably, but initial appearance is a big deal to a lot of people and a sign of what's to come and what's to expect. It just doesn't seem to match. I'll leave it at that. I've been trying to look at this and figure out what's going on. It looks like we've got a little cam lobe here, obviously controlled on this side by a selector switch integrated into the body. And then it's sort of just got the ribs right there. So obviously it's locked in place. If we switch this thing, good Lord, what are we supposed to do with this? Well, that's not reassuring. I mean, I'll give it this. It is definitely in the locked position. Which hand do I use? This is not good for a man with a bad thumb and a cut up left palm. Jeez. Well, I'm just gonna go ahead right now and cut to this moment in the video where I had that guy sitting in the wings waiting. And I will tell you right now, this is a vastly superior design from Style Villa in terms of the Flexit. How does this work, if you were curious? That's how it works. It catches. You press the button and you go. It's that simple. They are roughly the same length. The Matco is slightly longer. I was aware of the length and the similarities. Price point played a factor. And the other thing is, when I picked the Stavilla that I ordered for my birthday, I thought, man, you know, like, I think that's the sweet spot. You know, it's not too long. It's not going to be cumbersome and kind of like be held out of servicing in certain situations. And it's also not small enough that I won't be able to get leverage with it. So I thought, you know, it's probably smart to get a bigger size or a smaller size, but this was sort of what I thought the sweet spot would be. Weights are interesting. I'm going to get this out of there because, again, this is Matco. But, yeah, this stupid thing, I don't know what in the world I'm supposed to do, really. I'm trying to do what should be done, and it's just not happening for me. Good grief. So I can see what should happen. I mean, we should, if I'm not mistaken, slide this switch. That would release the ribs. It looks like it grabs several ribs. And then we would just flex in the position and lock it back. It ain't going at all. And like I said, with my hand, I'm pushing to the point I like feel the cut kind of straining. I'm using my crushed thumb now trying to get it, and it's not happening. You shouldn't have to have an instruction manual with this thing. So at this point in time, we're going to the Knipex combination needle nose. I'm going to see what happens. And did you hear it? Yeah, so I was doing it exactly right. The good news is, when this is locked, it should stay locked, at least initially. The other good news is, I don't think you will ever, at least in a new condition, inadvertently trip the switch and have the head flop. Okay, I literally had to use these. This is what I've been trying to do, is just flip that over, and it's not happening. I had to grab this, you know, the Knipex here to actually... It sounds great, I'm not gonna lie, like, even though that's a complete pain in the butt, it looks like we have way more positions available. Got it to go by hand that time. Oh, finally. Okay, so I'm thinking this will break in a little bit. Maybe it just needed to go. Good grief. Lord have mercy. Yeah, that's not fun. It's cool to have a flex head, but if it's like a royal pain in the butt to use a flex head, you're probably going to get a swivel head or use one that actually functions. This is not something I plan to have to gripe about. The Taiwan thing, yep, I was pretty ticked off about this. I didn't anticipate any issues. I guess I'm going to have to stand here in my spare time or while I contemplate what to do with my life and articulate this back and forth to try and make it functional. So... It just, I don't know if there's like a sweet spot. Maybe you have to go down slightly. That's how I got it that time. But yeah, I didn't anticipate having to play around with this thing so much. So going down seems to work for me. And then you kind of have to go up. So I guess, I don't know, it's really hard to see through the camera. So let me see if we can... Can't open my hand too terribly much, or kind of start to hurt, but you can see what's happening there with the design of it. But yeah, I mean, this is my bad thumb, but man, that's absurd. Yeah, I'm not a rocket scientist, but I would say that looks pretty dry. So that's unfortunate. Let's see, can we even lock it from that position? I think what has to happen is, when you get it, if you wanted it like full on flip 90 degrees, you've got to bring it up until you can get it to catch. Oh man, that really, this thumb is not near 100%, and that was a lot of pressure on it. So we're gonna come back over here like idiots and use these pliers. And that worked. So it could be me, it could be my, you know, like, I think the left hand would fare better if I didn't have a cut I was trying not to have open up. This, the thumb, as you should know, it is limited, but I think it shouldn't be that difficult. I think this should be a little easier to articulate. So that's, not gonna lie, a bit of a disappointment there. But in terms of aesthetics, I love it. In terms of a practical standpoint, that is a pain in the butt. The selector switch is stiff, but not a huge deal. The handle is really nice looking. It feels good in hand. I just think it's a little undersized. It's not balanced super well, but let's get to kind of the important part here, or one of the important parts, which is the head itself. It's actually a pretty slim head. We'll give it that. Okay, as I'm swinging this, as again, my first experience with an 88 tooth ratchet from Matco, sounds okay. I've just been doing a lot of coke and stuff, so, you know, like the back drag is kind of noticeable. It's not bad at all. It's just, you know, not quite on that level. But there seems to be like a bit more play than I would expect here, given this stiff as this thing is. Now, if this was flopping around and I could just swing it effortlessly, which I cannot do, I don't know. It's one of those things. Initial impression is less than ideal, like way lower than I expected. But I don't want to say it's garbage because I want to actually get to use it. I mean, I could wind up loving the ratchet just like that little Taiwan screwdriver could outperform the Witte for all we know, right? But yeah, that's not what I expected there. So we shall see. I'm very glad at this point in time I didn't buy the long quarter inch. But I won't totally rule it out until we've gotten to use this a little bit more. The good news is, if you've got a good pair of needle nose pliers and you didn't know what to do with them, keep them with your ratchet and socket because you'll need it for this selector switch to rotate it and unlock it. So this, I think when you get it in a spot, it goes fairly well, but man, I thought this would be a quicker video than this and I didn't anticipate all these issues, you know. Yeah, I don't know. If you have one of these, and I'm sure a lot of you do, let me know. Was yours like this? Was it like this initially and it broke in? Was yours never like this? Sadly, my 30-day window has passed. I got this when I was like down with the Rona. I think it's like literally just barely passed. I'm talking like we're probably into like 32 to 35 days past purchase, so... Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I need to track down the Matco guy, run on the truck, and see if all his are like this, or who knows. It might break in beautifully. This is just one of those things right now on the bench. Not super thrilled, but it has potential because it could work itself loose. It could break in. I don't know. Never experienced it. And like I said, it's my second flex head ratchet. I'll just tell you right off the bat, if that looks like a problem to you, there's a solution, and it's got a push button just like the quick release. So yeah, we'll see. I mean, we'll give it time. I'm not gonna say no, I hate it. I'm not gonna say don't ever buy this thing. I'm gonna say it looks really good. I think the handle's undersized. That's a big concern. Selector switch is stiff. It flops a bit for being that stiff. But aside from that, you know, it's, yeah, I don't know. Maybe we got like $50 out of the $189.95 that we can be happy with. So ultimately, I'm going to start using this thing. As much of a pain as that is, I'm going to use it. I'll keep the pliers handy. I'll always have needle noses around, so that's not a big deal. But I will use it. I will see if it breaks in. I'll report back, channel update or some random tool hauls down the line, let you know how it's doing. But it looks amazing. I just wish it performed you know, as good as it looked. So, but we'll see. We don't want to pass judgment, you know, condemn it just yet. Bench impressions, the aesthetics, great. Everything else is sort of gonna have to be determined over time. So I'll leave it at that and jump into what now will truly be a happy ending for us, because this is another item. This is something. I keep up with this stuff. I don't tell you about all of it, but I keep up with it personally. It's just something I enjoy doing. I saw these. I saw these were new by, you guessed it, Witte. And I was like, sweet. You know, and first thing I do is I go to KC Tool and see if I can find them. And I can't. And so the second thing I do is I email Colin and bother him. I say, hey, you seen these? When are you going to get them? You know, I'd like to buy a set. And this is something I don't know. Maybe they'll be able to get them eventually, but at the time I was talking to him, it was nothing that was on the radar. So we shall see. Maybe it'll be, you know, like a early 2022 thing for them. Who knows? From Matco, this is part number mag screw set. That's right. It was simple. I like it. Didn't have O's and zeros in it. Didn't have I's and L's. Didn't have 1's and I's and L's. Okay, it was mag screw set. Price point, not super happy with. $26.70. I think it could be half that and, you know, still be a decent buy. But this is a set. There's three items. If you buy them individually, you're getting ripped off. I mean, you're paying, I don't remember exactly, but it's a very high amount that is much, 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 much higher than just getting the three-piece set. So what are we talking about right here? This is knots. This is in the same case. You'll see if they're a Witte. It's a similar size label. Obviously doesn't have any mention of Witte or anything like that. But Matco tools, they're branded all over this thing. It is a magnetic screw holder set. Reduce frustration. You have something like that for the ratchet, Matco. Hold screws straight and lessen the risk of slipping and damage. This includes, and this will be important to you, 4.5, 6, and 8 millimeter fittings. So I'm going to see if I can open this or if it will also be a nightmare. And we did it. With my two bad hands, we opened it. So already off to a better start. Something cool here, okay? They're color-coded, and if you're thinking like, oh, that's kind of stupid. I wish they were all the same color or just black. Well, the way this is going to work, if I flip these over for you, it's pretty easy to tell. Green, is, and these lined up perfectly in order. So the green is going to be the 4.5. Orange is 6. And then we're going to have the blue 8.0. So if you didn't kind of piece together how this is going to work, let me show you. It's also capable of doing that. Well, we're going to take this brand new Matco driver and we're going to grab this and we're going to switch immediately to the middle size. Da-da-dum. And there we go. Slightly better. What we're trying to do is just seat this without poking my hand. And I got to position it just right for you. But picture this. That's kind of where we're going to be. And if you're thinking like, okay, so what's going on? And you'd think we would have somewhere a screw around here. We'll just grab this guy. No, that's not a good example. That's what I get for cleaning a little bit. There's always supposed to be a screw in that block of wood and there's not. Ah, there we go. Here's the block of wood with the screw. Okay, so this is it. If we stick this in here and we bring this down, it's going to be magnetic. This is a bad example. I'm not really prepared for this. I'm kind of frustrated, honestly, by the whole ratchet thing. That's kind of a disappointment. I had very high hopes for that. But you get the idea. This has the magnet. It will hold your fasteners as you drive them in. Everything here is stainless. That's not good for magnets. That's grade 5. Not a super strong magnet, but right there, that's actually a stainless nut, so that's a good sign. But obviously you can tweak the position. The catch is you have to have the tip make contact still or it's completely worthless. But that's what those are. I think what we will do is maybe make like a standalone video on those at some point in time, save ourselves a little bit of headache here. And it is something I'm pretty excited about. It's just I'm sort of washed and I was wanting to get another video cranked out so I can start trying to catch up. But with that said, this was our Matco 5K tool haul. And I'm not going to give up on this guy. I'm going to use it again immediately. That's the whole reason, as I stated before the disappointment set in. We were going to come in and we were going to use this guy, and that's why I wanted this video done, so I could have it out of the bag and start using it. And as I say that, we're starting to lose the voice completely. So I've got some wrenching that I need to do. If my hand gets to a point where I don't think it's going to bust open and start bleeding and, you know, run the risk of getting infected, we're going to use it. I'll update you how it does. Initially, aesthetics are awesome. Everything else is kind of in question. These I'm excited about because we've got, you know, colors from Witte, and then the Stubby, I've not been able to attain one. The Taiwan drivers actually look good. It's just a question of now, how do they perform? We'll have to figure that out over time. I wish, really, really wish more places were like Tecton and use the country of origin. Clearly, whether it's United States, Taiwan, China, whatever. Whatever they're making, they clearly disclose the origins. And that's a big deal to a lot of people, myself included, when you start to get up in the price, right? So, all in all, not terrible, but very expensive. That's my main takeaway from this, is very expensive. There's no tool of the day with Matco. There's no, like, you know, seasonal promotions from the companies, you know, like you'll have with the Vera or something. This is all just sort of like, here's our price. So, like I said, a lot of that does come down to the dealer, and I was operating through a website, so, you know, there's that disadvantage I'm already starting with. But excited to get these, test the screwdrivers out eventually, get this thing in use immediately. Whatever I'm doing, as soon as I get to do it, this is going to be my go-to, because I need to see if that thing is actually going to break in or not. I also might try, I'll start with light oil and see if that does anything, even on the switch. And then if not, I don't know if we're going to Crisco that thing or what, but something's got to give, because that's ridiculous. I realize, you know, I'm not in optimal condition to do things like that. Part of the problem, it's a great feature that the switch would be recessed that much, but when it's that stiff, you have no business recessing a switch like that, because it's just idiocy. So this is one of those things. I'm sure it looked great on the CAD software, but did you actually try it, you know, before you produced it? I don't know. Might be being too hard on them. We'll see. I do love the aesthetics. That's the main thing I want to take away positively. And the ratchet itself seemed, you know, decent. That's usually where people have the issues, of course. So currently it's looking like I would be on the camp of, ooh, you know, yeah, some of those do look good, but you might not, might go a different route, Timmy. I don't know, maybe it'll come around for us, who knows. But if you want to see more of this train wreck, let's get to 7,500 subscribers and we'll bring in some stuff from Mac that you recommend. So I should tell you, if you're thinking like, oh god, we don't need more screwdrivers, I've had these for a really long time, and I don't know that I ever made a video on them. They've just been sitting there waiting to be used, showcased, whatever we decided to do. But you'll at least spare yourself there, although I do believe they have a different style handle at this point in time, so you know, you might see one or two. Anyway, and I think their website's a bit better than Matco's too. Hadn't been on there in a while, but when I ordered those, I didn't have much trouble finding them. So with that said, I'm gonna quit rambling. I'm gonna get this cleaned up. That was one of my double-edged goals, you know, is while I can't do much, get videos done while I can somewhat talk functionally, clean the shop up a little bit by getting this stuff out of the floor, put away, and move on. So I will use this, whatever I'm doing, if I don't need anything, you know, smaller or bigger, this will be my go-to 3/8 for the immediate future. And whatever we're turning, whether it's Koken, SK, I don't care, Craftsman, this will be the ratchet, because I need to know if this thing is going to break itself in and be super cool and awesome and look great, or if it's going to be a total train wreck. And that's my main focus right now. So with that said, hope you enjoyed the video. Again, the biggest thing I guess to take away from this is thank you for coming to the channel, for choosing to subscribe. That you would not believe how many of you watch the videos all the time, and I'm not just saying you watch them, but like you actively comment, you like the videos, you comment, you send me messages, you know, and contact me on other means and sites and stuff, and you're not subscribed. So I don't know if it's a deal where just you watch the channel regularly enough, and I do this too, you know, like if there's some channels that I watch frequently, every time a video comes out, I pretty much always have it in my feed, right? And that gives you the sense that you're subscribed. But there are so many people that like are active, super active on the channel, really seem to enjoy it, you know, like interacting, leaving their thoughts on videos and tools and stuff, and they're not subscribed. So for the 5,000 plus of you now that actually took the time to subscribe or resubscribed, if YouTube unsubscribed you, that's still an issue from time to time, thank you. I sincerely appreciate it. This is an old channel. This channel dates back over 10 years. I've been doing this a long time. If you did not know, there's tons and tons of car content, car shows, walk-arounds, cruise nights, all sorts of stuff. You can check out Amarillo Area Mopars. That's where I used to kind of upload like the cruise night highlights way back in the day. And then we did a few tool things, did some tutorials, some how-tos, and then eventually kind of got into more and more on the tool side. And so that's sort of where most of the growth came from. So If you ever get bored, go way back in time. You'll see some crazy stuff, some cool cars. It's all Mopar. No Fords, no Chevys, no imports, all Mopar. Some of you will like that. Most of you will hate it. But I am at least consistent and steady with what I do and enjoy. So that said, I really enjoy this stuff. I like trying everything out, bringing it in, seeing it firsthand, seeing it in use, seeing how it compares. That's obviously why we've accrued such a ridiculous number of tools. And the ratchet thing, it just kind of sneaks up on you. I realized the other night, I was like, I actually have a lot of ratchets now. So that's nothing I ever planned to do. It honestly just kind of happened. So with this guy, I'm going to give it the benefit of the doubt that it will break in. I like to be positive. I like to be optimistic and look forward to great times in the future. That's what I'm going to end on. But if this thing doesn't break in, man, it's going to be a sad, sad waste. So I don't know. Maybe we'll fix it. Maybe we'll engineer something. Pull the cam out, you know, and maybe like file away or something. I don't know. We can probably make it better. But as of right now, I've got high hopes that it will deliver many, many, hopefully, proud moments of wrenching with what's honestly a really great looking ratchet. I just need it to function. I'd rather have the function than the aesthetics, you know. That's just me. But with that said, thanks for watching. I hope you have a fantastic weekend. If you buy from Matco online, hopefully you had a better experience than me. But again, seriously, those of you that have this, is this a known issue? Is this a common thing? Did you experience? Will it be fine in 2 weekends? Let me know. And maybe by that point, I will have found the same result. But yeah, I will use it. And you will see these haunting you in the future, in comparisons and showdowns, stuff like that. And I'll try to use these. I'm really into like the screw holding side of things. There's so many different styles, so many different takes on it. And this was one that I'd, like I said, discovered Witte had and was like, hey, gotta try it. So that's what we'll do. And that works really well with like interior stuff. And when you're on your back working over your head, that's when I primarily use those items. So that's what we'll stick with. But yeah, I'll quit rambling. Thanks for watching. Again, have a fantastic weekend. LoneStarMopars.com is the website. You know the drill. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all three at LoneStarMopars. If you have not subscribed and you want to see this same train wreck again, 7,500 and 10,000, spread the good word on the channel. And we'll see what we think of Mac and Snap-on outside of the Mac screwdrivers, which are the proto handles, which honestly, yeah, I won't spoil it. We'll just leave it there. So, yeah. Thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you back here next Saturday for more action from the shop.